fishing time.
Welcome to episode 3 with me, the Ginger Carp Man. You join me here at Clump Hill Farm Lake. Again, a bit of an unexpected trip. I was supposed to be in Oxford, fishing and filming up there. Most people have childcare issues. I have doggy daycare issues. Unfortunately, I couldn't leave Lily with the person I normally do. So we've come down here again for another day. Have some good news for you later on, some exciting news to tell you about. But in the meantime, let's get set up and I'll see you on the bank.
Thank you.
getting tight to the island. I don't think the bag's even dissolved. I haven't even put the bobbin on. And this, again, one of the smallest in the lake, I think. It's a very small little common, but as I say, everything's always good to catch something, so let's get him straight back. No point keeping him out, but just to show you. So yeah, bag didn't even, I don't think, the boat dropped the bait. Hadn't even had time to clip the bobbin on, and the line had pulled away. So yeah, it's a good start. Let's get him back. Well, good morning. You join me on the bank. All set up, the rods are out. So hopefully should be a good day today. Just I was putting the third rod out. I hadn't even had the time to put the bobbin on. Not even sure the PVA had melted, but line pulled out of my hand, and it was a small common, about 3-4 pounds. But it saves a blank. And as my friend Jay knows, who's had a hat trick of blanks, blanks aren't great, are they, Jay? And also, I got asked last week, by Josh in Oxford, when is episode 3 coming out? So hopefully you're watching this right now, Josh, and shout out for you. And hopefully you'll be getting your first carp soon. But yeah, today, got some good news. As you know, I've been fishing this for about 5 months now, pretty solid. And my aim was to get 20 out. I don't think there's many in here, I really don't. You'd be lucky if you're scraping 2, 3, 4, 20s. And then last week I come for just a quick day session, didn't bring any cameras or nothing, and within the first hour I'd had a chunk and a half. It took me about 15 minutes just to get it to the net, come up on the top, and I was gobsmacked when I saw it. I knew straight away it was a 20. In the meantime, while I'm playing that, my right hand rod screaming off, it just kept going and going and going. So I got the big one in the net, put the net down, got the other one, and I got that in as well. That was 10 pounds. So lifted the net out, and it was like, oh my God. So it was 22 pounds 6. I did have my phone with me, so I've got some footage that I'll put up in a sec. You can have a look, and some stills. That day was a good day. I had 6 fish, the 22, and a 14, a 12, 11, 10, and a little small 5-6 pounder. So yeah, it was a really good day. But I'd say I could put some stills up, a little bit of footage we've got of the fish once I'd landed it at the 22. But so no, that was really good. At least I've achieved my aim now of getting a 20 out of this lake. Don't know what today's going to bring. It was very cold when I got here. Still is quite chilly. There's sun coming up now. But there's also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 other anglers already, so there's a lot of lines in the water. But we'll wait and see. You never know, do you? Apart from that one I've had, it's been quite quiet. Guy fishing just opposite me has had one fish as well, so we'll wait and see. But yeah, so I'll pop up the footage now with the 22 and a few stills of the other fish I had on that day, and I'll speak to you in a bit. Check this out. Finally, 22 pounds 6 ounces. Oh my God, did it scrap right from down in the lilies. But oh my God, I'm so chuffed. I've finally done it. And what a lump. It really is a lump. I'm so pleased I've done it. I'm just going to flick it over quick, show you the other side. There you go again. What a beautiful fish. 22 pounds 6 ounces. Finally done it. Got a chunk of him. He's just, when I got him in the net. Okay, I'm going to get some stills. I am so chuffed. more. As I say, it's better than anything, so get her back in. But now you know what time it is. It's time for Ginger Grumbles. For today is electronic scooters, better known as e-scooters. Oh my god, they're a pain in the arse. How come when I was a kid you wasn't allowed to ride your bike on the pavement? If you did, the police stopped you. Yet these electronic scooters, they can ride them anywhere. They go along the pavement, they're doing about 20-30 miles an hour. The other day in Bournemouth, one shot straight across off the road, off the pavement, over the road in front of me. What happens if I hit him? It was a kid, about 13, 14. Do I get charged? They're a pain in the butt. And yet we allow them, Beryl, whatever they're called, we allow them. But they do my head in. They just go everywhere. They cut up in front of you, they jump off the pavements, they cut through the traffic lights. Do my head in. Ginger Grumbles for today. Well, I thought I'd have a bit of a chat about bait boats. I know it's a real controversial subject. I've been fishing many, many years. I remember when I used to fish carp fish, you just have a cork with a hair grip. I used to have my mum's hair grips drilled through, and you used to just stare at the bobbin all day long, just wait for it to shoot up. And then when optonics come along, I mean, everybody said that's cheating. You can't have, you know, bite alarms that tell you when you've got a bite or when you've got a carp on. Things have evolved all the time. Things are evolving. Baits have evolved massively. I think going back to the days of luncheon meat, sweet corn, chickpeas. Now look, you've got attractors now, everything bait wise. So I think this is just another sort of method that's, if used correctly, it can be a massive bonus. I mean, this winter I've used this boat, and without a shadow of a doubt it's caught me fish. Not the boat itself, obviously. Using it has caught me fish. In the other videos you've seen, I just tied to the island, and I go right under the tree where you couldn't cast there, and I have caught endless fish right tight to the island under that tree, putting the boat under there, dropping the bait and the pellets. I've caught endless fish from under there. The amount of times I've seen a fish jump, I've been here on my own on the lake, put the boat straight over to the fish because it could have been 100-130 yards away. I've caught. I've been able to put the bait straight on the spot where I wanted to, and I've done it first time. Yes, it's stealthy, but the problem is you have got idiots that are using them, sending them out 150-200 yards over other people's swims, and that's just letting it down. It's a great piece of kit. Say it's caught me so much fish. I just can't praise it enough. It's just the way things are evolving with carp fishing. Like I said, I mean, I go back 30 years ago when we stared at a bobbin all day long, a piece of cork, waiting for a bite. And then, you know, so many things, the bait runner come along. That was seen as, oh my god, that's just not fair. You should always leave your bail arm open. But so I think it's a great piece of kit. Used correctly, you know, I think they're really good. So yeah, I know it's controversial at the moment. There's a few lakes that won't allow them because of the mindless idiots that send them out 200 yards and cross over other people's swims. But no, I would say to anybody, if you fish a lake and you're allowed to use them, get yourself one, because they've really caught me fish this winter. Also, with the bait boat, I've got my sonar, and I've adapted it So I have that, and all I do is I clip that on, and that drags sonar behind it as I'm pulling the bait along. So you can have the hopper full up with the pellets, boilies, whatever you've got in there on your rig, and at the same time you've got your handheld controller that you can see the depth, and it also picks out fish as well. I don't rarely use it for that, it's more to do the depth because I don't like disturbing it. It's all right leading, but yeah, that's my way of my adaption I've made. And you can still tip the bait out, so if you do see fish right underneath you, you can tip the hopper up, get the bait out, and the sonar's still there, still being pulled along. So yeah, I think they're a great piece of kit. Good day. I think that cold just really did put them down. I say there was frost all over the ground when I drove here this morning, so yeah, it's not been a great day, and even made even worse because Oxford lost to Sunderland, so yeah, so not a great day. So I'm just going to start packing up, yeah, and then I'll we'll get everything sorted in the car. Because it's now, what is it, it's nearly 6:10, so Lily's starving, I'm starving, not the best of days, but you can't catch 6 and 7 every time, and you can't catch 22 pounders every time, so just be happy I got the 2 fish today, not exactly the biggest, but anything's better than nothing. But that's it. not sure where I'm fishing next, or where we're going, but it'll probably be next weekend. So see you on the bank very soon, and Ginger Cartman signing off.